Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I decided I would do something different, something new, something exciting. So after my 2 week break, during the exam period, I decided to buy the cheapest makeup NYKAA has to retail. Now this idea actually came to me from Laura Lee's video when she bought the cheapest makeup Sephora retails. And when I actually YouTubed it, a couple of YouTubers have done this kind of video. So I'm going to leave links to a few other YouTubers in the description section, but I have not seen any of the videos. I didn't want to confuse my thoughts about these products. I really found some hidden gems in over here that I would be using on a daily basis, and some new makeup brands I had no idea about. So if you're interested to know how the cheapest makeup from NYKAA can perform, please keep on watching. But before that, if anybody's new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button so you can join our family. If you're interested in beauty, makeup, content related videos, that's what we do here. So hit the subscribe button, join the family, and then keep on watching. Okay, so let's get started. For the first step in my makeup routine, it is primer. I did not order any skincare for this challenge. So for primer, when you search primer on NYKAA and put the filter price low to high, the product that comes is this right here. This is the VLCC Glam Glow Skin Perfection. Now I'm not very sure if this is a primer. So what it says over here, it's 10-in-1 Skin Perfector. It's in the shade Warm Beige. There were two shades, so I ordered the shade Warm Beige, and there is glycerin in this. So it would have a little bit of tackiness to it. So I guess that's the reason it came under the primer category. So this was for 128 bucks. This is as cheap as it gets in the primer category. I don't know how it's going to perform. Oh, this has a really, like a real tint to it, huh? This is not my shade in any way, shape or form, but there were just two shades, and with the cheap makeup thing, I think this is just going to be one of the problems. So let's just apply to our face and see how it works. I have a foundation also. I was planning to rub this with my fingers just like I do with primer. Very slippery, very slidey. Smells very rosy and nice. VLCC is a great skincare brand. I do like their toners, I like their stuff, so I don't mind putting this straight onto my skin. I don't think it will react with my skin. It has very safe ingredients. Massaging is just the way I would massage a primer. Okay, so looking at my skin in the mirror, it did even out my skin tone just a little bit. Of course, it doesn't have any coverage. It's like a tinted moisturizer sort of, so added a little glow. It has SPF. I can smell the SPF in this. So SPF 30, I think this is a good thing to like just put on an everyday basis and go out of the house. Plus it's so affordable. So I think I like this product, not as a primer, but definitely maybe as a tinted moisturizer, BB cream sort of. And since it didn't have any color to it, it did not change my skin color. Like BB creams do have some shade and they don't come in my shade. So yeah. So for the next step, that is foundation. I was really scared to get this item. Out of all the items, I think I'm the most scared for this one, because the cheapest foundation that you would get on NYKAA is this. So this is the Blue Heaven Waterproof Makeup Foundation. This is like a whopping 64 rupees. But there were like only two shades. In all of Blue Heaven makeup, there is only two shades in all of their foundation. I think one of them had four shades, but that was more expensive. The next foundation, which was like literally the next thing, was this NELF Moisturizing Makeup. So this is the NELF Moisturizing Makeup, and this was 94 rupees. So this was the next cheapest thing in foundation. So the NELF USA foundation had, I think, 4 to 6 shades. So I picked up the darkest shade in this one, and this is the darkest shade there is. This, even this like looks a little lighter for me, but this is like much closer than what this would be. I'm going to give both of these a shot. Also bearing in mind that NYKAA always has sale going on. I picked all of this up when they didn't have any specific sale on their website. So all of these are like always on discount, because I have tried to do this video a lot of times and added all of these to my cart, and the prices remain in the same range. So hopefully when y'all check, y'all find these only to be the cheapest. But even if y'all don't, know that when I was searching, these were the cheapest. This is the shade Natural, just by the way. The shade was, oh, this is like very, very watery. It's very pink. Oh, it's very, very pink. I'm going to start like on this half of my face, and then we'll mix in a little bit of the NELF because that's also cheap and that's my shade. Oh, this is like pink. This is so pink. Dude, this is very pink. I'm going to look like a fool at the end of this video. And the smell is also very, very cosmetically
sort of.
The smell of this foundation is like really bothering me, and I'm not one to be bothered by fragrances all that soon. It's so bothersome, it's like right in my nose. Okay, so this foundation literally blended into nothing. Like, can you see any coverage on my face? So I'm glad that it didn't leave like a pink film on my face. So this Blue Heaven foundation does nothing. This is not something you can use. Maybe you can use this on an everyday basis if you can let the fragrance go, because that fragrance is still bothering me. It's still on my face. But of course, for weddings or events, this is not a foundation you would like to try. Next, I wanted to try the NYKAA makeup. This shade looks much, much better. Like, just look at this. This shade looks better. This comes with a very weird sort of paddle doe foot applicator, and it's a very thick consistency. It's not liquid foundation. Like, if I do this, nothing's going to fall off because it's very thick, and you have to just like take it on this paddle and put it on your face. This feels great. Oh, this smells like rose. It straight up smells like rose water. See, I'm a full coverage person, so I'm going to go ham with this foundation because I really needed to do something for me. This is not blending well, look at this. I think I should try it with my finger, because like all of the foundation got absorbed onto my sponge. Everything is here inside right now, and whatever little bit was on my skin is spreading in the most patchiest way possible. Like, it's left this big patch. All the foundation from here went onto my sponge, and oh, not a pretty picture. I'm gonna go in with my finger. Ooh, it's giving coverage with my finger. I don't know why I feel like this is like multani mitti consistency. Looks like I'm applying a face pack, not a foundation. Like, smells like rose water, and the color is just like multani mitti, and I don't know. See, it's like rubbing off. Can you see? It's coming off. The more I rub it, the more it's coming off. How do I fix this? Okay, so I think this is as good as it gets. It doesn't get better than this. I was really hoping that the NYKAA USA makeup works. This is really feeling like multani mitti to me, because it smells so much like rose water. And as I do this, it's like rubbing and crumbling off and falling off. So yeah, so far I can only do this much to my face. I always say spend your money on base makeup, because if your base is looking good, the rest of the makeup will just float. So now, this is as good as my base is getting. This is a challenge. I want to do as well as I possibly can. Also, just a tip, if you have the NYKAA USA makeup already, using it with your hands is much better than using it with a sponge, because the sponge is just going to soak up all your product and you won't have anything left on your skin. So just a tip for all those who already have this. So next, I typed in liquid concealer on NYKAA, and when you type concealer, some rubbish pancake options come. I don't even know what's a pancake. I think it's something powder foundation format. But I wanted a proper concealer, so I typed in liquid concealer, and in that, the cheapest option was the Swiss Beauty liquid concealer. So this is the Swiss Beauty liquid concealer. Surprisingly, all the shades were out of stock. This was the only shade I got. This was the shade medium moyen, and this is the number 5. So I was hoping that this like suits me, but I've already swatched it and it's way too light for my skin. Not even close to the pack one. This is even worse, like shade wise. But this is a challenge and we have to work with what we got. So I'm going to take very little and see how light that is. This is like white. As compared to my skin, it's white. Oh, it's blending well. Smells also not that bad. Doesn't smell like anything actually. A lot. I went and looked at my face in the mirror, and up close it doesn't look that bad. Like, the foundation is fine, it's matte, so it's holding up well. The concealer is very oily, I'll give you all that. It blended like a dream, but the shade is of course very off. It's making my eyes look more tired, more grey and more dull, so they really need to work on their shade range, but for the price, am I complaining? Next, for powder, I got the Gala of London Sheer Finish Powder. Now I searched powder, setting powder or compact powder, I think, on NYKAA, and I'm going to leave screenshots over here of what I searched and what the results were. And so this is what came up. This MRP says 75 rupees, and this is in the shade tan. It comes with this thing that nobody ever uses, or people do use but you shouldn't, and this is the color. Does this look tan to you? Not to me, but in the pan this looks like a shade I can like play around and make it work. So I'm gonna take the e.l.f. powder brush and just lightly stipple this all over my face. It doesn't have any kickback as such, so let's see how much coverage this gives me. Smells straight up like talcum powder, not even kidding. You can really tell the difference with this powder. Like, this side of my face is so oily, so grey, and this just neutralizes it a little bit. So I do like this powder so far. I think this powder was a saving grace for me. Like, it does look very grey, and it's not camera friendly at all, but in person my skin is looking much better than what it was. With all the foundation and concealer mess going on underneath this, this powder really saved me. For an everyday basis, for office going people who don't want to spend too much on makeup, I think this is a great powder option. I got the shade tan, repeating again, and it's just 75 rupees. Now usually when I go wrong with my shades, the saving grace is bronzer for me. But today the bronzer I got ended up being an amazing highlighter. So this is the Stars bronzer. This is what it comes like. It's very small. So on my invoice it says it's 250 rupees. I'm not sure if that was the price of this, or this is the discounted price, or what the whole deal is. I am going to leave all the prices here, the links in the description, so you can be rest assured that y'all can go and buy this whenever y'all want. This is the Stars bronzer. Now this ended up being a shimmery bronzer, and when I swatched it, it was a gorgeous color. The packaging is very off because it has totally leaked in this box and even in my entire parcel. So the packaging is like not up to the mark. For 250, I think they could have done a better packaging. So this is the Stars makeup bronzer. I'm going to quickly open it. It is very dusty and very, very shimmery. This would work as a great highlighter. There is no way in hell I'm using this shimmery thing as a bronzer. It comes with this teeny tiny thing, and there's a sifter on this. So internally the packaging is good, just externally the cap was not secure enough. I don't know if I got a bad piece or just all of their packagings are like that. Taking a little bit on the Wet n Wild contour brush, I'm going to dust off the excess. Can you see how powdery that is? Yeah, this is doing nothing. I'm quickly realizing that this is doing nothing for my skin at all. I'm gonna take a little bit and swatch it at the back of my hand, and then I will blend and show y'all that this blends into nothing. So that's why it's blending into nothing on my skin. So this was a total flop. 250 rupees gaya mera. The other product still showed up. This didn't show up at all. So we are going to roll with it and go on to the next product. That's a blush palette. So when you search for blush, I don't think I searched for blush on NYKAA, I searched for blush palette because I wanted more variety. This is the blush palette that shows up. So this is the Blue Heaven Signature Blush Palette. This is actually 225, but on NYKAA this was retailing for 191 rupees, and when you search for blush palette, the lowest price is this. So I'm going to open it. I really like the Unicarton, by the way. So these are what the colors look like. This is the palette number 2. These are what the colors look like. So all of these shades have some tiny shimmer flecks in it. It also comes with a paint brush, sort of. Very tiny brush, which I would probably use for gel eyeliner. I don't know how can you apply blush with that. But I think I'm going to go for this very dark, mauvey sort of shade. Ooh, there is some payoff. Ooh, looks nice, pretty. I'm gonna use that. Trying to concentrate my stippling brush just on that pink color. So there is some color payoff. It also, because of the shimmer, it's adding this amazing glow to the skin. So praise the Lord, this is a good blush palette. God, this color looks beautiful even in first person. Dude, these blushes are amazing. I don't know how long wearing these are for the price. You get 4 colors, of which all these 3 colors are something I would use. This pink is something that will look very hideous on my skin tone, but anybody who's fairer will, I think, rock this pink color also. This is like a nice peachy, pinky in between with a nice glow to it. So yeah, I like this blush palette. This one's a hit from my side. Now for highlighter, you get this very weird options of shimmer dusts from Blue Heaven. These are actually supposed to go on the eye. When I actually got the product, I realized these will go on the eye. So this is what the box for the highlighter looks like. It didn't come with any unicarton. On the base of this, it does say Blue Heaven Stardust. So these were like 95 rupees is the MRP. I will mention for what price I got it. But the cheapest highlighter on NYKAA is this. I tried searching highlighter palettes, but then they were like 450 plus, so I didn't find the whole point of it being cheapest. So I went ahead and bought this. I thought I could play around with it, and if it didn't work, I would just skip highlighter. But I'm going to try to play around with this. Since we've put every product that I've purchased on my face, why not try this too? And let's not judge a book by its cover. This has a sifter in it. It's not a sifter, it's just a like regular cap. Oh, this looks so beautiful. I think on the eyes, this would look amazing. That's it. I'm not doing any more than that. I think my face makeup doesn't look horrible. I could have expected worse. This glitter thing is not the best for your face, so I wouldn't recommend it for the face. So usually after my face makeup is done, I set my makeup. So for makeup fixer, I got this Blue Heaven makeup fixer. It is a very heavy bottle, I will give you all that. It says mist spray on formula. This is for 300 rupees. This is the cheapest makeup fixer available on NYKAA. It says paraben free, goodness of aloe vera, vitamin E and vitamin B5. You get free 15% extra. So this is what it looks like. It's like a purple sheer bottle. I hope it's not purple liquid, but yeah. It smells like acetone. Oh my god, please don't tell me I put acetone on my face. Aqua, isopropyl alcohol, propylene, glycol, phenoxy, ethanol. There's a lot of alcohol in this. I'm not going to put any more, but like I don't even need setting for this makeup. I'm going to take it off after the video. But yeah, I think the mist was nice. The bottle is nice. The mist is nice. But it straight up smelled like acetone or alcohol. I'm not sure. Wait. Acetone. It smells like acetone. There is no acetone in it, but it smells straight up like acetone. Like even the NYX setting spray and all of the setting sprays almost have alcohol in them, but somehow the fragrance of this is making me feel like it's going to do something to my skin. So I'm not setting this makeup any further. We'll move on to the eyes. So for the eyes, lucky for me, the cheapest eyebrow pencil is the Miss Claire waterproof eyebrow pencil, which comes with this spoolie brush on the top. This is what I use in all of my videos. This is one of my favorite eyebrow pencils anyway. So I already know that it's going to work. I didn't get the same shade that I already have. I have the shade dark brown. That was not available on NYKAA. This is the shade 06 coffee brown. They have much more shade variety on NYKAA than they do in stores. Because in stores, I just had like 01 light brown, 02 dark brown. So I went for dark brown. This was long back. This is what I just got. Maybe Miss Claire has expanded their shade range, which would be a great thing. Okay, so let's get started. At least I know my brows will look good because I already love this product. I think they've reformulated their pencil. This is a little more creamier than I'm used to. I'm not complaining, but I'm just saying that what I have is a little different. Okay, so this is how the brows are looking. It is a tad bit darker than what my usual brow pencil is, and the formula has revamped the formula. But I do like this formula also. It's just a little more creamier than I'm used to. That pencil is more waxy. But you can definitely get your hands on this and be rest assured that your brows will look snatched. This is somewhere around 65-66 bucks. I'm gonna leave it here. But it's very affordable and it has been my tried and true since I started my makeup channel. So 2 years down the line, I still like this product. Now for the eyeshadow palette, this is a gimmick, but I already had this Blue Heaven eyeshadow palette. It was not mine actually, it was one of my sister's friends. And she left it at home for some days and I was playing around with it. And this swatch is like nothing, but this was the cheapest eyeshadow palette on NYKAA. So I said, why not show it on video and let others know that how it performs. Now, if from my sister's wedding up till now they've revamped their formula, I don't know. That was 1 year back. This is straight up all shade shimmer. Okay, there is no. This has something. The blue shade has totally crumbled. In transit, the blue shade has totally crumbled. There's something with my eyeshadow palettes and blue shades. They don't really want to stick with me. I dusted the blue shade off. This is what the eyeshadow palette looks like. It's straight up one of those palettes that school teachers used on annual day functions. So I'm going to play very safe with this and just select one shade and put it all over my lid, and then we'll work around that. So I think the safest bet for me would be this color, because others look very hot and neonish. So this looks a little pink red. So let's see if it's watching. Oh, there is some color to it. I really think they revamped their formula. Oh my god, I'm telling you, I was not lying. That palette was swatching like nothing. I'm going to work with this, okay? See, good, I gave it another shot. You should always give things another shot. Now, I'm not putting anything in a crease and an outer corner because there are no mattes with this and the colors are so vague from each other. Like, there's a pink, then a green, then a yellow, then a white. So, really don't want to do a bright look today. So, I'm going to go in with the red and play very safe. These are not even pride colors. Oh, actually they are, but if I'm doing a pride look, I'm not doing it with this palette. Listen, this looks beautiful. What is wrong with me? Was I not paying attention the last time I had it? Or like, blue haven't really stepped up their game? It does have a little bit of fallout. It is falling down, but we'll clean it up. I'm going to use the blush palette and try to fill my crease with some colors, and this is also Blue Heaven, so why not do that, make this a proper eye look. Ooh, yeah, I have something else for the eyes. How did I forget? Taking this pink color, the one next to the blush I used on a pack 311 brush. So there's a white shade over here. I'm going to try to highlight my brow bone with it. Really doesn't do much. Ooh, let's try that Blue Heaven Shimmer Dust on the inner corner. That would look nice. Okay, so I did the same thing on the other eye. And now for the product I'm most excited in this video for. Somehow when I typed in liquid eyeshadow, I found this amazing dupe. Like, literally this packaging is bomb. This is a Swiss Beauty liquid eyeshadow, and this is in the shade 03 Champagne. They have a lot of colors to offer, and I was so excited when I saw this. This packaging looks exactly like the Stila Magnificent Metals eyeshadow, and the formula, when I swatch it on the hand, looks just like the Colourpop formula. So I'm very excited. I'm very disappointed in this blue and been shimmer dust thing, because that's not up to the mark. So I'm going to just buff a little bit of the blush on the outer corner. Now for eyeliner, I'm using the Miss Claire Glimmer Sticks for eyes. So this is the Miss Claire Glimmer Sticks, and the cheapest eyeliner on NYKAA is Miss Claire. This is, I think, again 65-75 bucks. I will leave it here. I got the shade black. They have a lot of shades to offer. Just going to warm this up at the back of my hand because it's pencil. It is very pigmented. So I outlined my top lash line and the bottom lash line. On the top lash line, it was a little difficult to work because of the glitter eyeshadow. But on the bottom line, it was fair enough. Now, usually with such a look, I would love like a brown bottom lash line to add that smoky vibe to it. But today we don't have any brown shade in whatever we are working with. So again, from this blush palette, I'm going to go for the same shade that I used the blush, and try to make a attractive lower lash line. This Blue Heaven Shimmer Dust is really, really bothering me. So now for mascara, I got the Blue Heaven Walk Free Waterproof Long Lash Mascara. So this is what it looks like. It's blue from outside. I really hope it's black from inside. Oh yeah, it is. It is black from inside. Ooh, this is good. because I have so much going on in my eyes, you can't really tell that I have put mascara on, but I did buy lashes for this look. I thought since we are going all in, why not buy eyelashes? So the cheapest lashes on NYKAA were the Pro Art eyelashes in the number 03. This is $175. So I'm gonna throw these on off camera and be right back. Okay, so I threw on eyelashes and now we are almost at the end of the video. So I just have to throw on a lipstick. Now I bought something in both liquid lipstick and normal lipstick. So the cheapest liquid lipstick on NYKAA is the Blue Heaven Liquid Long Wear Lip Color. This is the shade I picked up. This is the shade Hazelnut. On NYKAA, this looked very, very shimmery, but in person, it's a beautiful nude color. So I'm first going to try this and then we'll top it off with a normal lipstick. Oh my god, this color is bomb. I'm just going to wait and see if this dries matte or it's going to stay glossy like this. Okay guys, so the lipsticks I got were the Inside Matte Lip Colors. I got two shades actually. They come in this beautiful cardboard thing and these are the colors I got. This was literally 80 rupees and when I swatched it, I was so happy with the color payoff. Like, this is the shade Nude Coffee. Look at the pigmentation on this. And this is the shade High Heels. This is like classic, right up my alley shade. Very, very vampy. So both of these colors are something I'm not gonna try on my lips today because I already like this lip color. I think a little bit of Nude Coffee, I will just top it off. But I do like this Blue Heaven lip color. It's not drying matte, it's just staying just the way it is. I think it added a little bit of pigment to the Blue Heaven color. The Blue Heaven is not that pigmented, but it is comfortable. It's a comfortable long wear lip color. So I think all in all, I'm very happy with the way this whole look turned out. It could have been 100 times worse than this, but there were some real standout products. Like the Swiss Beauty eyeshadow is beautiful, gorgeous. I can really see myself using it again. The lip colors are amazing. The mascara was taking a little more time to dry matte, but it did dry. The eyelashes are super. Pro Art eyelashes are anyways good. The powder was really great, something you can use on a daily basis. I actually kept repowdering my face because that glitter, that Blue Heaven shimmer dust is really falling off. So I really didn't like that Blue Heaven shimmer dust. I think that was the biggest mistake I did, to put straight up shimmer on my face and on my eyes. So that was a big time mistake. But apart from that, I am really, really happy with the whole makeup look. Did not like some products, straight up didn't like that setting spray, didn't like any of the foundations. Did like the VLCC skin tint, whatever it was. I see myself using that also. The eyeshadow was not so bad, so I judged it too soon. And the Miss Claire pencils anyways are my favorite. So I'm very happy I did this look. I discovered a bunch of makeup which is so affordable yet so great. This makes me want to dive more into these brands, and let me know which brand y'all are most excited to for me to do a full face off. I'm most excited for Swiss Beauty makeup because I think it performed very well. Let me know if y'all have tried any of these products and do y'all have them in your kit and do y'all like things, because I know Blue Heaven is a brand people do use on a daily basis. So yeah, let me know what y'all thought about this video. Leave all your thoughts and have a nice chat down in the comment section. I always reply to comments on my videos, so I will get back to y'all. And if you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe and show your love. Today we complete 2 years of this YouTube channel. Today the day I'm filming this, and we are so close to 10,000 subscribers, so I hope we reach there very soon and keep growing this family. I will see y'all in my next video. Bye guys, love y'all. Mwah.